Hi. It's the end of the wildfish migration day for us now. I've actually been sitting at my desk all day, plugging away on the social media posts, so it's really nice to get down to the river just to finish things off. So my name's Jennie. I'm the communications officer, and it's really lovely to be here at the end of the day back by the river. I hope you've enjoyed coming on our journey up the Severn with us today. It's been really fun to go on a bit of a journey following the shad's route up from Gloucester and further that river, and I hope that you've seen some of the videos along the way. We've stopped at Gloucester to see our art installation Glimmer, and you can see that in person this week if you're near Gloucester, and that would be really lovely if you want to drop in and see that. We then went to Tewkesbury with our volunteering officer, who talked us through the citizen science that takes place there, which is a really important location for us because it's where we get our eyes on the shad, and have volunteers along to help us with that, which is great. After that, we went up to Worcester and we had two videos for you in Worcester. We had Rosie, our education officer, on Diglas Island, showing you the work we've done in the workshop, the space that we've created that we're going to bring school groups to. And we also then went over in the rain to the fish pass on the other side of the weir and had our program director showing us around the fish pass. So that was really good to see. Then we went a little bit further upriver. We went to see our new completed fish pass at Beverley. And finally, we went to the Lincoln fish pass, which is still very much in the construction mode. And then we finished our clips with Alex this afternoon from the Severn Valley Country Park, where we have some lovely play equipment for children. And she was also talking about our exhibition, our Unlocking the Severn exhibition, which starts next Wednesday, well, it's this Wednesday, in Ironbridge. There's a gallery next to the Jackfield Tile Museum. So we'd really love those in the area of Ironbridge to come along and have a look at that. It's actually going to be in Ironbridge until the end of February, so there's plenty of time to go along and see it, and you can learn lots more about the shad and their migration on the River Severn. So I hope you've had a chance to see some of the videos. I hope you've enjoyed it. If you have any questions, feel free to, you know, send them through to us. We'll be picking up again and checking whether we've had any more kind of comments and interactions over the weekend next week. Couple more bits to mention from me. We sort of see this wildfish migration celebration as something that started at the beginning of this week with one of our talks and is going to carry on all through next week. Next week is actually half term in this area, and we've got loads of really fun stuff for children that are at home, starting on Monday with the River Kids Learning Hub, which is a whole day of kind of really fun activities and crafts and all sorts of stuff. And we've actually partnered up with five other Rivers Trusts to deliver that content on Monday. So look out for that on Monday if you're at home with children, or even if you're young at heart and fancy joining in. And we'll carry on posting some of our own activities through the week. Next week, which is half term, we're going to have unlocking fish fun every day of half term. So there'll be plenty of things to look forward to. Even if you are in Wales and you're in lockdown, look out for that stuff. So I hope it's given you a good flavour for the project. Obviously, we would have loved to have seen you in person, as was the original plan, with an open day for Wildfish Migration Day. But hopefully, this way, with a virtual activity, we've actually covered more ground. So hopefully there's a few more insights there for you. We're going to do a playlist of all the videos that we've put on Facebook today. So if you want to go back and re-watch any that you missed during the day, then they'll be available for you. And I'm just going to wrap up there and say thanks for your support. We're always looking for volunteers. We're always looking for supporters. So if you haven't been to our website yet, which is unlockingthe7.co.uk, then make sure you go there and you can sign up for the newsletter. On the bottom of every page of the website, there's a space you can enter your email address to make sure you're getting updates from us. We send out a newsletter about once a month, but it's definitely not going to fill your junk box, but we'd love to keep in touch and let you know what's going on. And the other thing to end on, a bit of an ask, this is Wellfish Migration Day, and sometimes it's hard for us to really engage with the wildlife that we can't see that's beneath the surface of the river. So if you, like us, do feel passionate about the fish in our rivers and their need to migrate, and you'd like to show your support, then our invitation and our ask for you is to get on whichever social media platform you use, Twitter or Instagram or Facebook, and just put a post out there. You can put a photo in if you've got a picture of you by the river, or just some text explaining why this matters to you, and use the hashtag #StepUpForFish. And we'd really love to see everyone kind of showing their support, because the guys and girls, the fish that are down there, you know, it's challenging times for all the wildlife in freshwater systems, and we want to show our support and we want to kind of raise awareness. So if you can play a part in that, we would really appreciate it. So happy Wellfish Migration Day. It's been great to have you along, and please stay in contact with our project. We've got lots more to come in the future. Bye.